Welcome to everybody to my channel DigiLearner. I am going to present my second lesson cum PowerPoint presentation on the subject matter of political obligation. This subject includes core 3, that is the political theory and concept debate for the second semester students. In this lesson, I am going to present what is political obligation. In this lesson or come PowerPoint presentation, I am going to present grounds or basis of political obligation. Why do people or citizen obey the state? So now we shall discuss about some of the grounds of a political obligation and why the state is obeyed, why the people oblige the state, what are the reasons. Let us discuss some of the grounds of a political obligation. A question arises in everybody's mind, why people obey the laws of the state and oblige the state. Firstly, legal sanction of the state. The state has the legal sanction. The state is the law-making authority. The laws and decisions of the state of the government are backed by the legal sanction. The coercive power of the state to award and enforce the punishment are used only against such persons who are found guilty of violation of any kind of legal obligation. Secondly, mighty power of the state. Mighty power of the state. The state is mighty or most powerful institution, organization in the state. The state is omnipotent and almighty, has only sovereign authority. So all the citizens respect for the mighty power of the sovereign authority of the state. Hence, they obey laws and oblige to the authority of the state. Thirdly, rationality and usefulness of law. The laws are rational and useful, so people obey the law. Law is the only means to an end, not an end in itself. People will gladly obey the law if laws are proved itself to be useful instrument for human welfare. Next is the fear of punishment of the state. Disobedience of law to law is caused punishment. The state punishes the individual, those who break or disobey the laws of the state. Hence, citizens obey law because they wish to avoid punishment. Those who violate the state shall be punished by the state as per the laws. So all the individuals are obliged to the state law. Next one is the necessity of the state. The state is a necessary institution. So state is omnipotent and universal. Without state, there is no essence of the individual. Individual is not secure without the state. So the individual aware that the state is necessary, purposeful and positive institution. It protects life, liberty, rights, property of the individuals. State is a natural an essential political community of the people which performs the functions of ensuring security, peace, order, welfare and development of all its citizens. It undertakes several social welfare activities, hence they have to cooperate and render obligation to the state and obey its law and order. Next is the fear of anarchy and instability. The people or the citizen obey the state, oblige to the state due to fear of anarchy and instability. If there has been anarchy, instability state, their right, liberty are not protected, they are endangered. Instability and anarchy shall prevail in the state if citizens are not obliged to the state and disobey the state law. Instability, disorder, anarchy in the state endanger their lives, liberty and property. Human beings who desire to have peace and order can never imagine living in a lawless society. Hence, the fear of disorder and anarchy makes the citizen law-abiding, obliged to the state. Next is the religion. Religion is one of the reasons or grounds of political obligation. Religion is one of the major sources of law, and most of the laws are brought from religious ethics. All religions preaches the moral value, ethics, and moral or good conduct of the people. Religion increases the moral value of the man as a spirit. People believe the king or ruler was the represented God. Religion preaches to obey the authority of the state. Religious factor is also responsible for obedience of law and under obligation to the state. Next is the legitimacy of a sovereign behind the law. The government is a legitimate agency of the state which makes the law, and that should be constitutional and legal. The law is the command of the sovereign. The state enjoys the sovereign authority to make law. So, law has the legitimate sanction of the state. Disobedience to the state law causes punishment. Hence, all citizens are obliged to obey the law and render obligation to the state. Next is the public opinion. Public opinion is one of the major grounds of political obligation. The laws and policies of decisions government are based on public opinion. They are governed by the objective of securing the welfare and development of all citizens of the state. So, in this chapter, I included some of the important moral questions for forthcoming university exams of different universities for the students of second semester. So, in this chapter, I included some of the short questions also. Thank you very much. I request you to subscribe my channel for your further notification of the next or future videos. Then I also request you to like and subscribe my channel and share the videos of my channel among your friends. Thank you very much. Thanks.